Hi everyone, I'm Tom. Today I'm going to be playing Arkham Horror, the card game, and this is a living card game, so this is just a small starter box to get you started with. It plays 1 to 2 players, though you can buy two and play with 3 or 4, and it's going to be endlessly expanded. So before I do anything in the game, I'll just let you know that there are spoilers in this. The campaign that comes in the box has got 3 chapters to it, and it's quite short, but the first scenario especially, which is what I'm going to be playing, is kind of just a tutorial. There is there is story involved, so that's going to be spoiled for you if you watch, but I don't think it's very much personally. But if that bothers you, then you know, feel free to not watch and wait and play it for yourself. But if you don't mind knowing a little bit of what's going on, then let's get started. So the campaign that we're given for the base box is Night of the Zealot. So, The Ghoul's Hunger. Friday, September 18th, 1925, Arkham, Massachusetts. It is the end of a long and abnormally hot summer. The first hints of autumn beckon, but a heavy heat persists relentless. A silent, unspoken anger grips the town. Tempers are short, and in the last week alone, there have been numerous reports of townspeople coming to heated, violent blows with one another over simple misunderstandings. And now, a call from James Hankerson. He claims to have found a dismembered body in his barn. Blaming the weather would be too easy. There is something wrong with this town, and not a whole lot this old soothsayer can do to stop the slide. My auguries indicate that a small group of investigators will soon take note of these strange happenings and set forth to make things right. I'll be watching their progress, but I won't be holding my breath. So that is the little intro for our campaign. So I've already set this up here. It shows you how to set up the, you know, the locations, the acts, the mythos deck, which is basically the enemies and events that they're going to try and stop you. Then you need to assemble a chaos bag. You need to find some kind of bag or a cup, as I have here, because a cup is a lot easier to draw from with one hand. And based on your difficulty, you put certain tokens in it. So you can see that if you want to just do easy, I want to experience the story, you get more plus ones and kind of less minuses. There's more zeros, and it only goes down to -2, whereas the higher difficulties, you get fewer good things and a lot more bad things, and a lot worse as well. The penalties are a lot worse. So for this, I'm going to be playing standard because, you know, if you call your difficulty standard, that's what I'm going to be trying. And we are ready to do part one, the gathering. So there's another bit of story to start this off, and I'll do my best to try and keep the spoilers off the right-hand side of the screen there, the ending. So you and your partners have been investigating strange events taking place in your home city of Arkham, Massachusetts. Over the past few weeks, several townspeople have mysteriously gone missing. Recently, their corpses turned up in the woods, savaged and half-eaten. The police and newspapers have stated that wild animals are responsible, but you believe there's something else going on. You are gathered together at the lead investigator's home to discuss these bizarre events. So the lead investigator in this case is Roland Banks, who is a by-the-books federal officer, and everything by the book, every I dotted, every T crossed, it had worked until now. You know, nothing in his by-the-book training prepared him for this. And we also have Wendy Adams, who you may remember from going insane in the Mansions of Madness. She's all better now, and she is ready to take on this mystery. So in the game, we both have starting decks that I have just made based on the, you know, the recommended list that came in the How to Play guide. A big part of this game will be, you know, crafting your own deck. There are things that let you modify your deck going through the campaign. But I'm sure that you can, you know, pick and choose a perfect strategy and try and find a perfect deck to get through the game as best you can. So we are in Roland's house, and there are a couple more story things to start the game off. First, the agenda deck, and we read the top card. It's kind of organized into 1A, 2A, 3A. So we read 1A to start the game. What's going on? It is late at night. You are holed up in your study researching the bloody disappearances that have been taking place in the region. A few hours into your research, you hear the sound of strange chanting coming from your parlor down the hall. At the same time, you hear dirt churning as if something were digging beneath the floor. And the act deck. So we are trapped. As you leap to investigate, the door to your study vanishes before your eyes, leaving behind only solid wall. You're trapped inside your study until you can find another way out. And these decks serve different purposes. So the agenda is progression of the bad stuff. We don't want this to progress. It is going to, at least once every round, this is going to get worse and worse, and, you know, ultimately probably make us lose the scenario. The act deck is what we do want to get advanced. We need clues to get the act deck to advance, and we will kind of find out more about the story and maybe given some different objectives as we progress through that. We also have a little reference card here which shows us symbols that are in the chaos bag. Certain symbols are defined by the scenario that you're doing. So I think we're just about ready to get playing. So we're in the study here. You can see the door has vanished. You've been investigating the strange events occurring in Arkham for several days now. Your desk is covered in newspaper articles, police reports, and witness accounts. So since we're in here, thanks to our mini cards showing that, we reveal the study. The door to your study has vanished. So this shows us the locations that are linked to our study. Surprisingly, none, because we haven't got a way out. This is the shroud value. This is how hard it is to investigate in the study. And this is how many clues there are in there. And this symbol next to the two means per investigator. So there are two clues per investigator. So that's the main thing there. This per investigator symbol is what changes for the number of players. It's not always just the clues that change. It can be enemy health or all sorts of other things. But that's the main, if you're wondering about the pure solo and just playing one character, that's the difference. So we have four clues to investigate there. You can see we need two per investigator to advance the act deck. So we're gonna need all of these clues. So I will just come over to the round sequence here. So we have the mythos phase first, but we skip this during the first round. So we can go straight to the investigating phase. Each investigator takes a turn and performs three actions. The actions you can take are draw a card, gain a resource. Resources are these. We start the game with five, and they will be needed to play cards out in front of us. Play an event or asset card from hand, and that is how we use the assets. We play a card, and we have to pay that many resources. We can activate an arrow ability on a card, so if I haven't got one in front of me, but if I had played a card with that on it, I could use another action to activate that ability. I can move to a connecting location, although nothing connects to the study. I can investigate the location, and this is how we get the clues. We have to make a test to see if we discover any clues in there. We can fight or engage an enemy at our location. We can attempt to evade an enemy in a location. These abilities do not cost actions. So for example, on this card, they don't take abilities. If you're engaged with an enemy and spend an action to do anything other than fight, evade, or activate an ability, each enemy engaged with you makes an attack. So that is all of the action stuff. So if I want to investigate, I need to use intellect. The shroud value is 2. My intellect is 3. So if I just made a basic investigation action, I would draw from the cup, and the number that I drew would modify my 3, and I would have to get 2 or more to be able to succeed and grab one of these clues. To help me out with this, in the cards that I've got, I can just say I'm doing an investigation action, and I can play as many cards as I want from my hand and just commit these symbols to the skill check. We ignore everything else on the card but these symbols. I can do this for as many cards as I want, and every investigator that's in the same location as me can commit one card. And you see here, Wendy has got a couple of intellect cards herself. But I have started off with Dr. Milan Christopher, Professor of Entomology. And he is an ally. And if I play him, I will get +1 intellect. And if I successfully investigate, I will gain a resource. So I think I'd like to get him out. He is going to cost 4 resources. So that's 4 of my starting 5 gone, but I think he is going to be very useful indeed. And I can always gain more resources with this card. So I think now I'm going to try and investigate. My intellect is 4 now, thanks to Dr. Christopher. And so we draw from the Chaos Cup, and I get -1. So 4 - 1 still beats the 2, so I can grab a clue, and that goes on Roland. The chaos tokens all just always go back into the bag, so you've always got the same variables every time. So that was 2 actions, and I think for his third, he's going to try and investigate it again, I think. See, he could just get resources, but I think he might as well try and investigate. So he's got 4 again, and he pulls out -1. So he succeeds there again. and he has two clues ready. So that was Roland's investigation phase. Now we move on to Wendy. I just realized she had a weakness in her hand. You're not supposed to have a weakness to start with. But here we go. Looking at Wendy's cards, she has started out with Leo DeLuca, the Louisiana Lion. And he's an ally. You may take an additional action during your turn. That's really, really nice. So I think Wendy is going to use her first action to gain a resource. So now she has six. Then she's going to spend all six to play Leo. And then she's got two more actions because she now gets an additional action. So the one she took to get the resource is kind of cancelled out. So now she could try investigation checks, but if she got anything more than a plus one, she would fail because she has three intellect as well, and she doesn't have anything to boost it unless she wants to commit the sneak attack there, but that could do two damage to an enemy. Maybe she wants to keep that. I think she's just going to make an intellect check to investigate, and she draws minus one. There are other things in that bag, I swear. And so she succeeds at that, just about. And her last one might as well be to do another investigate. So plus one, so even better. This is far better than it's ever gone when I've played this game. Okay then. So at any time, unless the objective says otherwise, at any time, if you have the required number of clues, you can advance the act. So we are going to spend our four clues and let's advance the act deck. So, the door on the floor. You notice that the edges of your newly purchased rug are tattered and mud-stained. Finding this odd, you shift the furniture aside and pull back the rug. To your surprise, you see the door leading out of your study. You slowly turn the knob and the door swings open, revealing your hallway below. You jump through the doorway, landing on your feet on soft dirt. The door to the study slams shut above you. The smell of burning wood fills the narrow hall, intermingled with the scent of rot and decay. So now we have some instructions. Put into play the set aside hallway, cellar, attic, and parlor. So I did this first before we started. So we have these locations. Let's put them on their undiscovered side. So we have the parlor, the cellar, the attic, and the hallway. And we can see these symbols now. From the hallway, you can get to the locations with these symbols, which happens to be all of these three, and all of these symbols only link back to the hallway. So to get from any of these locations to another one, you're going to have to go through the hallway first. Then discard every enemy in the study. Well, we didn't even get to that. Place each investigator in the hallway and then remove the study from the game. So we are here in the hallway, so we can reveal that. So first we had, a moment of panic and disorientation strikes you as you land upon the floor of the hallway. The world spins as if turned on its head. And we reveal it. The walls of your house are splattered with mud and your hardwood floor is gone, replaced with a dirt path. So there is a quite easy shroud value in this, but there's no clues in this hallway. And we're going to need three of each here. So I should read Act 2A as well now. So we are done with that act card. And we move on to this, the barrier. A glowing barrier blocks the path to your parlor. As you move through it, intense heat forces you to back away. Picking up a handful of dirt, you toss it at the barrier and watch in horror as the dirt incinerates. Perhaps there's something in the cellar or attic that can help. So now we have an objective. When the round ends, investigators in the hallway may, as a group, spend the requisite number of clues to advance. So we can't just do this at any time now, we have to do it at the end of a round in the hallway. And so we can't get to the parlor, so the clues are going to be in these places, presumably. But that was the end of our turn, so we can move to the enemy phase. There are no enemies yet. They would attack if they were out. And then we can go to the upkeep phase. So we reset actions. Oh, well, you are supposed to, once you've done your turn, you're supposed to flip your guy to show that you're done. But we found that you can quite easily remember who's done their actions. I suppose in a game with more players, you might want to remember that. So ready all exhausted cards. If we had exhausted any, they would rotate back. Each investigator draws a card and gains a resource. So we both get a resource. And let's see, I draw a 45 automatic. That'll make me good at attacking. And Wendy draws scavenging. After you successfully investigate by two or more, exhaust scavenging, choose an item card in your discard pile and add it to your hand. That could be quite nice. And then you have to discard down to eight cards if you've got too many. And now we go to a new round, so the mythos phase, which does happen now. Place one doom on the agenda. And once the agenda gets 3 doom on it, we advance it if the threshold is reached right now. Each investigator draws a card from the top of the encounter deck, so I will start. And I find a ghoul minion. It's a humanoid, a monster and a ghoul. It was a colossal and nameless blasphemy with glaring red eyes and held in its bony claws a thing that had been a man, gnawing at the head as a child nibbles at a stick of candy. Oh dear. So, we have a few numbers on an enemy. Here's to fight him. You're going to need a strength of 2 at least after modifiers. He has 2 health and you are going to need a 2 on an agility check to evade him. So he immediately engages me and we are probably going to be doing some fighting. And then for Wendy, ancient evils place a doom on the current agenda. This effect can cause it to advance. Oh no, so we have 2 of the 3 needed on there, so the start of next round, that's going to advance. That's not good, but I imagine it could have been a lot worse. So let's do Roland first. He is engaged with the ghoul minion, so remember, if you do anything other than fight or evade, he is going to attack, so, and he does a damage and a horror, and we don't want that, so let's try and stop him. Unfortunately, I haven't got my gun out yet. I could try and evade him, and then I could get my gun out and try and kill him. That could be an idea. So let's try and evade. So to evade him, I need to make an agility check. My agility is 2. I am going to use my manual dexterity, so I can only use 1 of these per skill test. If it's successful, draw a card. Wendy could contribute her switchblade to help me if she wanted, but let's... let's try and evade. So I get the skull, and in the gathering, the skull means minus X. X is the number of ghoul enemies at your location. There is 1, so I get a minus 1. So that is still okay. That's enough. That goes back into the cup, so I can draw a card now. Mind over matter. Play only during your turn. Until the end of the round, you may use your intellect instead of fists and agility. So the ghoul minion has been evaded and is exhausted. So he is no longer engaged with me and he is not going to do anything in the enemy phase. So we could just leave him here, but I think I'd like to take him out. Unfortunately, my gun takes 4 resources. I could play this and then get the gun, but then I'm kind of just standing in the hallway fighting. But the gun will set me up for later. I could have just fought him as well using fists and I'd just do 1 damage a time. Okay, I think I'm going to leave that ghoul behind. Wendy can take care of that ghoul. So I am going to spend my second action to move to the attic. Let's see what's in the attic. So the smell of rotten meat assaults your nostrils as you approach the attic stairs. Forced, after you enter the attic, take a horror. Oh, that's not good. Because Roland can only take 5 horror before he goes insane. Okay, the bloody carcass of a malformed beast swings from a meat hook chained to the ceiling. Blood drains slowly from the carcass, dripping into a small barrel. Okay, that's why he took the horror then. There are 4 clues in here, and the shroud value is only 1. So surely, I could do some good investigating here. I'm going to investigate for my third action, and so my value is 4 for intellect, and I need a 1. That's a minus 1, so that's okay for me. And I get my first clue on there. So this should go to the location because I'm not there anymore. Now Wendy could use her sneak attack right now because that would just kill the enemy without needing a check. And Wendy is not that good at strength checks. So she could gain 3 resources using that card. Then she could play sneak attack, spending 2 resources. And the ghoul is now, has been dealt 2 damage, his health 2 damage. He is done for. So Wendy has got 2 more actions. I think she'll come and join me in the attic. So she takes a horror and she might as well try to investigate. I think she'll try to investigate first. So she has 3 intellect and she needs a 1. Oh dear, minus 4. So she fails. And that was her action. So there are no enemies. So we skip that. Upkeep phase, reset actions, ready exhausted cards, draw a card and get a resource. So Roland gets the medical texts. Choose an investigator at your location. Test intellect. If you succeed, heal a damage. If you fail, deal a damage. And Wendy gets overpower. So this is one of those special skill cards that gives her 2 strength, which is good because that's what she is quite bad at. And then we discard down to 8. We haven't got 8. So the round sequence, we place a doom on the agenda, and that's 3 doom. So the agenda advances, which is something we don't want. So, a lapse in time. Your house continues to change before your very eyes. The walls have decayed and the ground in many rooms has turned to dirt. It's almost as if you've been transported somewhere else entirely, although every now and again you recognize elements of your former home. The lead investigator must decide. Either everyone discards a card at random, or the lead investigator takes 2 horror. Well, the lead investigator is not very good at taking horror, so I think we should discard a card at random. So I will just shuffle these up and pick a card, and it's the guard dog. That's a shame. The guard dog would, when an enemy attack deals a damage to guard dog, because you can assign damage to allies, the dog would deal a damage back. But he has gone. And for Wendy, hopefully she keeps her attack cards that make her a bit better at that. So she loses the switchblade, so 1 of her attack cards. So that's agenda 1A gone, that's agenda 1B gone. So, the new agenda, Rise of the Ghouls. The floor beneath you is giving way, and you see a vast network of tunnels twisting into the darkness below. Shapes and silhouettes of strange creatures move swiftly through the tunnels, trying to find a way up. You probably don't want to be here when they do. So that's probably what's going to happen in 7 Doom Tokens time. So now we draw from the encounter deck. So I get a ghoul minion. We've seen that. And Wendy gets Grasping Hands. It's a hazard, so she needs to test agility, and she needs 3 to succeed. She's got 4 in her agility. She is in the same place as me. I could help her out. I don't really want to spend my thing. Let's see, I don't want her to take a damage. But do I want to waste my card for that? I think I'll hang on to that because I could use that to use intellect instead of agility, and now my intellect is better. Either way, I want that card. So Wendy is going to try and test agility. She gets, the cloaked figure. That means -1 if you fail, take a horror. But 4 - 1 = 3, so she succeeds at that. We are okay, so it comes to me. So what do I want to do? Do I want to try and evade again? I need to get this gun out. We could, though, choose for Wendy to go first. And she could try using her knife to take down this ghoul minion for me. Yeah, let's do that. So she is going to put out her knife, which is a resource. And she could use overpower. Maybe she wants to save that, though. Let's see. She gets +1 fight for the attack, or she could discard the knife. She would get +2 to the attack and it would do extra damage. She needs a 2 to succeed, and at the moment she has 1 + 1, 2 strength. I think she's going to use overpower, so now she has 4 strength. And she draws from the cup the Elder Sign. That's really good. So +0, if the amulet is in play, you automatically succeed instead. So she didn't actually need overpower, which is a shame, but she spent it. She gets to draw a card because she succeeded and used that card, so she gets Hard Knocks. If this is out, she can spend a resource and get +1 for strength or agility, so she might want to get that out. So she succeeded, and she did 1 damage to the ghoul minion. She could fight again, and I think she might as well, because I'm better at investigating anyway. So she's got 2 more actions. I think, yeah, let's... She's going to attack again, but she's not going to add anything to it. And she gets +1. It's the shroud again, so that's -1 if you fail, take a horror. Oh dear. So she only has 2 strength, doesn't she? So this means bad stuff. I think she is going to discard a card because she has a special ability. When you reveal a chaos token, choose and discard 1 card from your hand, cancel that chaos token and return it to the back. So she's going to discard Scavenging, so that goes back into the bag, and we draw a new one, and it's 0, so she succeeds and kills the ghoul minion, which actually, thinking about it now, isn't a great thing, because Roland's ability is, after you defeat an enemy, discover a clue at your location. Anyway, it's done now. The ghoul minion has been taken out by Wendy. She has one more action. I think she is going to draw a card so she gets some more options. So she draws, look what I found. After you play after you fail a skill test by two or less, discover two clues in your location. That would be brilliant. She wants to fail a skill test. So my turn. There is no enemy engaged with me anymore. So I am just going to go and investigate, I think. Actually, I want my gun out. I am going to play this and get three resources. Then I'm going to put my 45 automatic out, which costs four resources, and it gets four ammo on it. So when I want to use this, it uses up an ammo, and then I get plus one strength for the attack, and it deals plus one damage. So that will be really good. So that was two of my three things. So I'm going to investigate now. I need a one, and I have four intellect. So four minus two, that's okay. I get another clue. But we need to get moving with this. We keep getting caught up with enemies. But it's because I didn't have weapons. Now I've got this weapon, I can just take them out and get clues while doing it. So upkeep phase, basically we're going to get a resource each and then draw a card. So Roland gets guts, which helps him with willpower. And it's the same as the others we've seen for the other types. And Wendy gets baseball bat. You get plus two strength for this attack. It deals plus one damage. If these symbols are revealed, you discard it. So it can break, but that would be good for Wendy to have out. But you can see these cards go in certain slots. So she has this knife in her hand. If she wants the baseball bat out, that's going to take two of her hand slots. So she would have to get rid of the knife. So she would probably want to attack with it first and discard it before she put this baseball bat out. Anyway, mythos phase, we put a doom on the agenda. So it's got one out of the seven it needs. Then we draw from the encounter deck. So Roland gets a swarm of rats, and these are hunters, so these will follow you. Wendy draws Crypt Chill. She has to test her willpower, which is four. If you fail, choose and discard an asset you control. So she doesn't have anything that would help. I could discard, I could help her with guts. I could do this, and then I'd get to draw a card if she succeeded. Yeah, I'm going to help her out. So I'm going to commit guts there because we're in the same location. I can commit one thing to her test. And so she has six willpower. She needs four. She gets plus one. Brilliant. So I didn't need to use this, but I have just kind of swapped it for another card. And it's the one that gets me more resources. So she succeeds and we just get rid of that crypt chill. And now it's actions. So I don't think I am going to use my gun. I think I'm just going to fight. So I just make a combat check using my strength, and I need to beat one. So as long as it's not a minus four, oh, it's this broken tablet thing. So minus two, if there is a ghoul at your location, take a damage. There's not a ghoul, and minus two is okay. So I deal a damage, it's got one health, and it is dead. So now I am going to investigate twice, I think. Oh, and for defeating an enemy, I get to discover a clue at our location. So that is another clue. And let's see, since the shroud value is only one here, Wendy could probably sort that out quite easily. Maybe I should go over to the cellar and investigate there. But I'm gonna have to go hallway, then cellar, and then we're separated. But Wendy could get to me, she's got a lot of actions. So I am going to do action two, move to the hallway. Action three, move to the cellar. So, the stairs leading down to your cellar are slick and they glisten with a thin layer of ice. So, after you enter the cellar, take a damage. Oh no. But he's quite good for health, he's got 9 health. And your cellar seems to have been replaced with an underground network of icy tunnels and caverns. The cold chills you to the core. So the shroud value here is 4. Wow. And it has 4 clues on it. And that's where I am for the end of my turn. So Wendy is going to try and investigate. Oh, this should be back in the cup. So her investigation is 3, her intellect, minus 1. So 2 is okay. So she gets that clue. So that was action 1. Action 2, let's go there. Action 3 is come to the cellar and she will take a damage. And let's see, action 4, she would like to fail this by 2 or less. So she is going to just try and investigate with her 3. So she gets minus 2, So that's a one. So she can't use the look what I found, unfortunately. But that would have been really nice. She's probably just going to keep trying that. And then she, even if she failed, she would get two clues. I think that's a good thing to do. And hopefully we'll get an enemy down here and Roland can kill it and he'll get clues from that. So that was the end of the actions. So we grab a resource each. And draw a card. Roland gets Old Book of Law. Exhaust it to choose an investigator at your location. That investigator searches the top three cards of their deck for a card, draws it, and shuffles the remaining ones back into the deck. Wendy draws Survival Instinct. If this skill test is successful during an evasion attempt, the evading investigator may immediately disengage from every other enemy engaged with them and move to a connected location. So now we go back to the top, put a doom on the agenda. We've got two of the seven. Advance it, nope. And we draw a card. So Roland gets Crypt Chill. And that's bad for Roland. Let's see, he could commit some things to it. Wendy hasn't got anything that could help. Let's see, he could commit this because he's just going to fail. And he doesn't want to discard an asset. These two assets are really nice. So I think he's going to commit these two cards so he has five willpower. And then he's going to draw from the cup. And he gets this, which is minus two. If there's a ghoul there, take a damage. So he doesn't take the damage, but that's minus two. He is going to lose an asset. So he either loses his gun, which he doesn't want to lose, or he loses his professor. He doesn't want to lose either. But that's just the way it went. He's wasted these cards. And yeah, Dr. Christopher is going to go away. And how many times has he investigated and not had a resource? He should have loads more resources. Oh well, that's my fault. So the Crypt Chill really affected Roland there. Let's see what Wendy gets. Grasping Hands again. So she needs to make an agility check. I think she is going to commit this Survival Instinct. And so she has five agility, minus four. So for each point you fail by, oh dear, five minus four. So she takes two damage. It's not that bad. And we can take our turns. So I think Wendy is going to try and investigate. She's going to go first and let's see how many things she can get. So she gets an Elder Sign. So she hasn't got the amulet, but it's plus zero. She's failed by one. So she is going to play Look What I Found. So this isn't an action to play this. Play after you fail a skill test by two or less while investigating. So she pays the two to play the card. And she discovers two clues, just like that. And, oh, I'd been thinking we needed all of these, but we only need six. And we've got six. So it could be time to just skip our turns and go to the hallway and let's see what happens. But we might as well. So that was one action, wasn't it, of hers. She might as well play something else. I think she'll save the baseball bat because she can use the knife before she gets rid of that. So she'll play Hard Knocks. So she's going to get some bonuses later on. And then action three can be go back to the hallway. And action four, let's draw her a card. She has a leather coat, which is basically just some basic armor. I'm going to draw a card because I don't particularly care about these ones. Research Librarian. I can put him out. He would absorb some damage. And I can get a tome asset into my hand. Yeah, let's just do that. So two resources to do that. And then let's find a tome. Actually, my only tome is out here, so he wasn't a very useful one to play. So this is where being familiar with the deck would help you. But it's going to absorb some damage if we take some damage, so it's not that bad. So that was one action to do that. And then second action will be to gain resources, I think. So he's ready for later. And then third action, he's going to move to the hallway. So we have to do the upkeep phase, which is basically just still, since there are no exhausted things, just draw new stuff. So Roland gets a flashlight, which helps investigate. Okay, and Wendy gets A flashlight, okay. A bit bad timing for that, maybe. So the end of the round, though, where's that? Here we go, the barrier. When the round ends, investigators in the hallway may, as a group, spend the requisite number of clues. So Roland got 3. Wendy got 3. So breaking the barrier. Using the barrel from the attic, you carry ice and snow from the cellar and hurl it at the barrier. The barrier sparks and shudders as it consumes the ice, then hisses and fades out of existence. The barrier blocking passage into the parlour has vanished. Reveal the parlour. You're unsure what would happen if you tried to cross the threshold of the strange barrier, but based on its extreme heat, you sure as hell don't want to try. And now we have... Oh, we have found some crazy stuff in there. Put the set-aside Lita Chandler into the parlour. So this lady has been found in the parlour and spawned the set-aside ghoul priest in the hallway. Here we go. This guy is now in the hallway, and he is going to engage the person with the highest strength. That happens to be Roland. And the next act, what have you done? A woman with a torch stands in your parlour, a glimmer of hatred in her eyes. What have you done to my barrier? She screams, furious. Before you can answer, a ghastly wail sounds beside you, and a creature wearing robes and a deerskull mask tears through the wall, advancing towards you. So our objective now, we have no clue value here. If the ghoul priest is defeated, advance. So that is our objective now. So we can go to the parlour now and basically resign. We can just run out of the front door. Or we can try and control Lita, who will give everybody a strength bonus. So I think it would be a good idea for somebody to run off and go and try and get Lita. So that was all the end of the round. So the new one, we place a doom on the agenda. There is 3 out of 7 now. And we do the cards. Roland gets ghoul minion. Oh dear. And Wendy gets frozen in fear. Put frozen in fear into play in your threat area. The first time you perform one of the following actions, move, fight, or evade, it costs an additional action. At the end of your turn, test willpower. If you succeed, you can discard this. That's bad, but at least she's got an extra action. So she could go and get Lita, but I am going to be taking 3 damage and 3 heads from this. So, and I'm not very good at evading. So I could play this actually, because it's not spending an action because it's fast. And I could use books instead of agility, but that only boosts it by 1, and just using the card for there would. So I'm a bit unsure of what to do. Should Wendy attack? Should she just run over there and try and get Lita, though she only has 3 books? She does have the flashlight that she could commit, so she'd have 4, but she would need a 0. So it would cost 2 actions to go there, 1 to do that, and then 1 to come back. She could do that. So I think for her first action, she is going to attack with the knife. So if she discards it, she gets +2 strength for the attack and it deals 1 damage. This does only give her 3 strength, but she would take the ghoul minion out because the ghoul priest has 5 health per investigator. So that's quite a lot. So let's see what she gets with the knife. So she gets -1. So what does she have? 3, -1. So she kills the ghoul minion. So at least that's a bit of pressure off me. So that was an attack, wasn't it? So that cost her 2 actions. The first time she fights, that's 2 actions. She could keep fighting. She could also go to the parlor. I think she is going to sneak off and run to the parlor with her 3rd action. And then her 4th action could be to just try, but she could just try and hope for a +0. Yeah, she'll commit the flashlight for its book symbol. And she needs a 0 or a +1. I think there's like 3 chances of her getting that. -4. Okay. Oh, she can. Let's just scoop that. We can discard this, though, and she can draw another card. Though she is discarding a lot of stuff then. Yeah, I think she's going to discard it and try and draw again. That seems like a silly idea now I say it. So the shroud thing is -1. So she fails, doesn't she? And if you fail, take a horror. That wasn't a good idea, and she's lost her armor for that. And what am I doing? I could try and evade him, because then he'd be exhausted and he wouldn't be able to attack. But I am so bad at evading that I can't actually get 4 evade with the stuff that I've got. I can't draw a card because then he would attack me. Okay, then let's try and whittle him down a bit. So I have 4 strength. If I attack with the gun, I get 5 strength. I need 4 to beat him. I'm going to commit this card. So I have 6 strength now. So I'm going to attack with the gun then. So I spend, just the one. I spend an ammo. So I've got 4, 5, and then 6 for the medical text versus his 4. And I get the shroud, which is -1. So that's okay. I do 2 damage to him, which with 10 health isn't that much. But hopefully Lita is coming back with Wendy soon. That's one action. I could do... See, I don't want to fail because he has retaliate. Let's try and attack again and use mind over matter. So I have 6 strength again. -2 is just enough. So he now has 6 health, but he is going to attack me. But I can take one hit and hopefully Wendy can come back and engage him and get him off me. But I can't risk attacking him and him hitting me because he would kill me. Because his attack would do 2 horror. And then his normal attack in the enemy phase would do 2 horror and I'd be done for. So I'm going to just end my turn early, which you can do. So that was it. The enemy phase. Each engaged enemy attacks if able. So he does 2 damage to me. And 2 horror. So I'm not in great shape mentally. And then upkeep phase. So we get some resources. I need something to use my resources. So I have found a knife. And Wendy has found unexpected courage, which is 2 of anything. It doesn't let you draw one like those other ones, but these can be used as anything. So that will be very nice to try and get Lita. So she's going to go first, I'm pretty sure. We haven't got 8 cards. We've actually only got 2. So Doom on the agenda. That's 4 of the 7. Then Roland gets a card. Ancient Evils place a Doom on the agenda. At least it's not another enemy. So we have 5 on there now. Then Wendy draws a card. Dissonant Voice. Oh, she should have done this at the end of her turn. So she has 4 willpower. She needs to test to see if she can get rid of this. So she gets -1. She gets rid of that. But what's this new thing that's affecting her? Dissonant Voices. Put it in your threat area. You cannot play assets or events at the end of the round. Get rid of it. That's okay. It's not as bad as it could be. This is a skill. And you're just committing it as well. You're not playing it, even if it had been assets and events. That's a shame because she can't get her baseball bat out. We can now come to the investigator phase. Wendy's going to go first. She's going to play Unexpected Courage for intellect. So she now has 5 intellect and she needs 4 to get Lita. So she gets the Elder Sign, which is +0. She still hasn't got her amulet. Where's her amulet? This deck is still quite big though. We haven't really drawn many cards from it. Okay, so she gets Lita. So she has taken control of Lita Chandler. So when you control Lita Chandler, she gains each investigator at your location gets +1 strength. When an investigator at your location successfully attacks a monster, that investigator deals +1 damage. So that's brilliant. She will come back to the hallway. So that's 2 actions. Third action, she is going to engage the Ghoul Priest. That's just an action, engage. And that means that the Ghoul Priest comes over to her instead because Roland can't take another hit, whereas she can. Actually, Roland could have taken another hit because of the research librarian. But anyway, Wendy can take more. So she has 1 more action. She could spend 2 resources, so she would have 4 strength. And then she would need to draw a 0 from the cup. And what are the chances of that? I think before she engaged the priest, she would have just drawn a card. So she's got that for next time. So she's engaged the priest. Now, yes, I'm going to attack using the gun. So I have got 5 strength plus 1 from Lita. I've got 6 strength. And this will do a lot of damage if it hits. So I've got 0. So that hits, it deals +1 damage from the gun and +1 damage from Lita because it's a monster. So he now gets 3 damage on him. So it's not 3, 5, 7. This could finish him off if this hits. So I am going, so I've got 3 actions. I'm going to commit the knife to this. just because I want to succeed. So I've got 4, 5, 6 from the knife, 7 from Lita. So only the -4 would stop me here. -1. So that's another 3 damage. The ghoul priest is done for, and we can advance. So, when the robed creature falls, the fiendish swarm burrows back into the ground and the chaos of the house quiets, but the stranger in your parlour doesn't seem relieved. You broke my seal that was set up to trap the ghouls within. She raises her torch. Now we must take more direct measures and burn this hell pit to the ground. The lead investigator must decide. It was never much of a home. Burn it down. This hell pit is my home. No way are we burning it. And that is a decision that you would have to make to end the scenario. And I'm not going to read out the kind of branching things that lead to the next scenarios. So you would go into a section that starts, do not read until the end of the scenario. And based on what you did, if people were killed, if you ran away, if you chose number 1 or number 2, you would get a different ending. And it would tell you to do some things. And they would affect the next scenarios. And they can start to affect it in quite big ways. One thing I will show you though is experience. You earn experience through these adventures. So I don't think we fought any enemies that provide experience apart from the ghoul priest. So the ghoul priest would give us 2 experience. Every location that was fully explored and provides victory points. So like this one would. This provides experience, whereas the cellar was not fully explored. That wouldn't provide us experience. So we would have 3 experience each because of these 2 cards. And then you can go into the big deck of unused cards and go through it. And you see this card here has these kind of grayed out dots here. Other cards have dots in them that are costs. So we would be able to buy 3 pips worth of cards and you can just upgrade them. Like certain cards have just got better versions of them. Other cards, you can just take a new one and you would have to discard something from your deck so it stays the same size. But so there is evolution through the story by earning this experience and being able to spend it on the better and better cards. And so after this, you would be able to go on to the Midnight Masks scenario, which is a lot more involved than this. It's a lot longer. It's a lot, it's not complicated. There's a lot more going on in it. There's a lot more locations and things at the same time. There's more to do. This is just getting you warmed up for the game, and the kind of showing off what Arkham Horror can do is in the second scenario. But there's even more spoilers in that, so I don't think this spoils very much. But that was Arkham Horror the card game. We made it through surprisingly well, better than any of my attempts when I haven't been filming it. So that was Arkham Horror the Card Game. I hope you enjoyed that and you got a good impression of what the game is like. If you'd like to know what I think, then you can click the link on the screen. But thank you very much for watching and I'll see you for the next video. Bye!